that happened here?
Some kind of fight took place. From the height, it looks like maybe the T-Rex and something bigger?
The Indominus Rex. I don't think we have to worry about it anymore. Or what's left of it.
Ugh. Or the Mosasaurus being hungry for a while.
The ending of Jurassic World shows us the death of Dr. Wu's Indominus Rex. The park's first and only officially endorsed hybrid was attacked and subsequently killed by Jurassic World's massive Mosasaur, an animal that would eventually drag it underneath the lagoon and finish it off away from the audience's point of view. However, in subsequent Jurassic World sequels, the remains of the I-Rex have been seen on two separate occasions, in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom and later the second season of the Netflix series Camp Cretaceous. Both instances actually give us some pretty unfortunate clues as to how the animal really died that not many people seem to have brought up at all. Now, upon first glance, it would appear that the Indominus Rex was simply dragged under the water by the Mosasaurus in Jurassic World and killed via drowning. This would basically imply that it wasn't necessarily the attack by the Mosasaur that killed it, but rather the lack of oxygen that the animal would endure underneath the lagoon's surface. And while this could be a pretty clear explanation as to what immediately happened to the animal, the more recent glimpses at its remains tell us other things about the kill. In Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous, after the kids miss the boat, they make their way back to Main Street, and while there, Brooklyn and Darius soon discover what's left of the Indominus Rex in the Mosasaur Lagoon. Now, from their points of view, whatever body parts and pieces that were left of the I-Rex would have to be pretty close to the surface, which means that whatever it was that they were looking at would have to have not sunk to the bottom of the lagoon, and it would have to be clearly visible from the area in which the Mosasaur broke through. Well, these body parts aren't shown on screen in the episode. The protagonists make it clear that the sight isn't exactly pretty, but also that it's kind of obvious that this carcass had to have been the Indominus Rex from the way they talk about it. Now, flashing forward around 6 months later, towards the start of Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, Eli Mills' mercenary team goes into the Mosasaur Lagoon, searching for the remains of the I-Rex in order to make the Indoraptor. Now, here's where things get kind of interesting. If you pay close attention to the arrangement in which the skeleton has settled itself at the bottom of the lagoon, you can see that each bone isn't exactly in its anatomically correct position. With the ribcage sticking up to the surface, we're led to believe that the main body of the animal had to have fallen to the bottom of the lagoon. However, the head and limbs of the Indominus are a totally different story. If the I-Rex's head were actually attached to the main skeleton, it would realistically mean that the dinosaur would have its skull settled upside down on the bottom of the lagoon. However, the exact opposite happens to be true here, meaning that the dinosaur's head appears to have been twisted all the way around and torn off of where it's realistically supposed to be. Now, whether or not it was the Mosasaur that did this, and not just decomposition that took place after the dinosaur died, is currently unknown. However, the body definitely does appear to have been ripped apart and separated if we take the separate Camp Cretaceous scene into consideration with this reveal. The arm of the Indominus Rex also shouldn't be resting where it currently is either in relation to the overall skeletal structure of the dinosaur, and since we already know that humans could easily look over the side of the lagoon and visibly see pieces of the Indominus exposed close to the surface floating up there, I don't think it's too crazy to think that the Mosasaurus tore this thing apart as soon as it brought it underneath the water. Now, had the Indominus Rex not had its head turned all the way around and instead been settled at the bottom of the seabed normally, like what we can assume happened with its rib cage, then I don't think I would really give this carcass much thought at all. However, an animal as massive and heavy as the I-Rex wouldn't just have pieces of its bones bobbing around the water for no reason at all. I mean, think about this. We see the skull of the animal in a position where it's not really supposed to be. It's implied that the Mosasaurus obviously ate some of this guy. It was probably tearing off chunks and swimming around while doing so. But for the head to be detached in the way it is, and the same thing with the arm, it makes me believe that it didn't exactly eat those parts of the body. So, was this how it killed it? Who knows? The idea that the Mosasaurus actually began to rip this creature apart and that we can see evidence of it happening after the fact in Fallen Kingdom's intro feels like it may actually make more sense than just guessing on whether or not the reptile's tail slapped against the I-Rex's skull or some small oceanic life nibbled their way into totally flipping the skull over in between films. I don't know, that could have happened, but Sounds a little odd to me. And the same is true, in my opinion, of the Indominus Rex's arm. With that being said, I think that the real information on how the body got torn up like this comes from Camp Cretaceous, with Darius saying that it looks like they wouldn't have to worry about the Mosasaur being hungry for a while. I'd say it's quite possible that they're implying that the animal would routinely swim up to the carcass of the dead hybrid and begin to tear chunks of flesh from its body in a way similar to that of Komodo dragons, which are basically giant monitor lizards that share family with the Mosasaurs. As such, I'd imagine that after taking the Indominus underneath the water, the creature may have opted to drown it at first. That could have been what happened. But eventually, sometime either before or after it died, the animal would soon choose to tear flesh from it, somehow severing the head or some other parts of the body as well, which is more than likely why we saw the protagonists of Camp Cretaceous act the way they do at the beginning of Season 2. You've got pieces of this creature just bobbing around in the water, easily visible by these children that look over the edge. Kind of creepy, in my opinion. But hey, these are all just my own thoughts on the subject matter. Now, I'd like to hear what all of you think. Are you of the opinion that the Mosasaur simply drowned the Indominus and didn't actually begin to eat it until much later? Or do you think that as soon as the creature went underneath the surface, it was game over, and the marine reptile had already begun to rip it to shreds? Now, whatever your own thoughts and opinions happen to be, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below. Now before I go, I'd like to thank all of my game wardens, as well as all of my in-gen executives. I'd also like to thank all of my parkers and in-gen hunters as well. Guys, it seriously means the world to me that you all continue to support what I do, and I never want you to ever forget that. Now, I'd like to thank you all for watching today's video and hope you all enjoyed the content. If you feel like I deserve it, I'd appreciate the like and hope that you'll consider subscribing if you're interested in seeing me again. See you all in the next video, guys, and as always, take it easy.